So this is our RSD project. It's called Nucleus. It's a type of a spherical vehicle that can be used in place of the two-wheelers or the cars that are used right now. The main benefit of this vehicle would be, like, for the two-wheelers, it would be giving a protection to the rider, and for the four-wheelers, it would help in the parallel parking and during the traffic. Okay, so basically this is the head of the Nucleus through which the driver can see inside stuff, whatever the obstacles are there on the road or the surroundings near him, he can get it through the field through the camera that is on the head. And this is the body or the sphere in which the rider sits, and which rotates as a free wheel, and it rotates not as a wheel in only one forward or backward direction, but it rotates as a sphere in all the directions. Now I can show it to you, like, this is the signals that we are going to give. Like, if the ball is moving towards backwards, it will show you the red light, the white light. If the ball is stopped, it will show you red light. If the ball is moving forward, it will show you green. If the ball is going, like, left side, it will turn on the left indicator. And if it is going on the right, it will turn on the right indicator. So this indicator lights are for the vehicles that are coming from the back side, whereas the driver can see from the front camera. The camera has an angle of, like, 180 degrees in each direction in a horizontal plane, and it can also go up and down for a better view for the ground as well as a big part of the sky. Now I'll show you the inner mechanism of the Nucleus. So the nucleus is basically it's a hollow sphere inside, and it has the mechanism for working. The ball rotates with the help of the omnivills that we are using over here. You can check the omnivills. Here are the omnivills that we are using for the rotation of the ball. We are using omnivills so that it can go in all the directions. This helps in the rotational, the movement of the ball in sideways as well as the front when the motor moves. We are using Arduino to program this thing. It's connected to the Bluetooth to be connected with the head. It also has a gyroscope, accelerometer sensors to keep the position of the body always steady in a perpendicular direction with the horizontal plane. That is used because if the person is sitting inside, we don't want the person to get tumbled with the ball, so the plate needs to stay steady. This is the head which is connecting the main head on the top. It goes inside the ball, and it is used, like, it has magnets underneath which connects to the magnets that are underneath the head. This is the head that goes on the top of the sphere. It is not connected physically with the head of the inside the sphere. It's connected with the magnets. Due to this thing, it stays always on the top because the plate will always stay parallel to the ground. And we are using an app to control this whole thing. The app is, you can see over here, it controls the ball movements are controlled with the motion sensor, whereas the camera can be controlled with the arrows that you can see in the app. And whatever the app would be controlled by the driver who is sitting inside. So if the driver is sitting inside, he can control this app and he can get a real-time view of the image that is happening outside. And we are using a TCP protocol for that thing. We are using a Raspberry Pi for the head. The camera is connected to the Raspberry Pi, so it has a different connection, and it has a different power source. It works separately from the sphere, but it is connected with the Bluetooth, so the driver can control both the things at the same time with the use of the single app. Yeah, so the ball that you see over here, the ball and the head, is totally 3D printed in the printers that we have over here in the uni. And so it is lighter, it is stronger, but it's not that strong enough. So for the future improvement, we can make the ball with some other material that can be as strong or more strong than the material or the 3D prints that we use right now. But it will be much more thinner than this, and it would be a bit lighter than this, so that to get a free and a good motion inside. And for this project, the programming of the head and the body was done by Fernando. The mechanical designing and the 3D printing was done by Dhyanbhat, and the whole thing was assembled by Dhyan and Abraham. And so that's it from the Nucleus. Okay, so this was from the team Nucleus, and now I leave you with some of the tests that we done on the Nucleus and some of the videos of its working.